Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to apply conditional formatting and suppression to management reports in Enterprise Performance Reporting Cloud. Conditional formatting enables you to apply formatting to cells in a grid if the values in those cells meet predefined conditions. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to set conditional formatting to display a different background cell color depending on the cell value. Conditional suppression enables you to suppress rows or columns in a grid based on specific attributes or values. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to suppress rows depending on cell values in a column. I have already created a report that shows actual versus planned values by region and includes a variance percent column. I'll edit the report and open the grid editor. I'll select the cells for the variance percent column and open conditional properties. You use the conditional properties panel to create and maintain conditional formats and suppressions. I'll select formats and then add a format. I'll enter a descriptive name for the format. This name must be unique for the grid. The applies to field lists the areas of the grid that you selected. Note, you can modify the values in the applies to field to change the area of the grid where you want to apply the condition. In the expression builder area, select an attribute to begin defining the condition that must be met for the conditional format to be applied. In this example, I'll select current cell value. After you select the attribute, the operator and qualifier fields change to reflect the available parameters. Select an operator and enter a qualifier. Now I'll specify the formatting for the condition. In this example, cells with values greater than 0% will display with a green background. The sample at the top of the panel displays the selected formatting. Click OK to save and close the conditional format. The Conditional Properties panel displays the conditional format. I'll add another conditional format. This time, I'll create a yellow conditional format with two expressions. Cells with values less than 0 and greater than minus 10 will display with a yellow background. I'll also add a red conditional format where cells with values less than minus 10 will display with a red background. I'll preview the changes. The conditional formatting is applied. Now I want to create a conditional suppression that suppresses all rows where actual revenue is less than $500,000. I'll return to the grid editor, select the rows where I want to apply the suppression, select suppressions, and add a suppression. I'll name the conditional suppression and create a condition that will suppress all rows where data values in column A are less than 500,000. I'll click OK to save the conditional suppression and then preview to confirm that the grid suppresses the expected rows. If I return to the grid editor, you can see that when a conditional format or suppression applies to a cell, row, or column, a triangle indicator is displayed in the upper right corner. When you hover your mouse over the indicator, a tooltip displays the list of conditional formats or suppressions that apply to that cell, row, or column. When you hover your mouse over a condition, a tooltip displays the cells it applies to and the conditional expressions. With a region of the grid highlighted, click the checkbox next to the condition to select or deselect it, which applies or removes it from that region. If you want to apply an existing format to other cells or regions in a grid, select the cell or region in the grid and then click the checkbox next to the condition to apply it. Click on the name of a conditional format or suppression to edit that condition. Use the arrows to change the precedence of a condition. Click X to remove a condition. In this tutorial, you saw how to apply conditional formatting and suppression to management reports in Enterprise Performance Reporting Cloud. For more information, please visit cloud.oracle.com.